YouTube, good morning, Derek Dimes, Ghost Picks ATS, your nation's number one trending sports handicappers. If you're new, welcome to Dime Time. I truly do appreciate it. Hover around this logo at the bottom, click that, go up top. Make sure you turn notifications on so you'll be notified every single time we go live, give leans, give you any type of information. We did have a live feed yesterday, very good feedback. We actually had a discount top tier month, so if you were in that live feed, the invoices had already went out. So make sure you take care of that within the next couple days so we can get you on board and get you linked up. But yeah, it was great. Good feedback. A lot of leans on college football yesterday. It was a good day. So let's get right to it, guys. Win, lose, or draw. Very transparent. Five expert cappers here on the Ghost Picks team. Click the description down below. Make sure you follow those guys, all right? You want to follow along and take advantage of the information we're providing for you every single day as we are looking to lead the nation here. And sports information, make you guys more successful sports bettors, and help you grow your bankroll, all right? Let's jump right into it. Yesterday was not our best day, not our worst day, but it was a winning day. So we wanted to try to continue to win and continue to move forward here and try to grow your bankroll. It is Sunday fun day, $20, guys, full card, any capper of your choice. You get everything we have to offer today in the NFL. So jump on board, Sunday fun day, $20, full card, any capper. All right, let's jump into it. Yesterday, I gave you kind of two free plays because one of them was on my card, one of them wasn't, and it was kind of late for the one. So we're going to jump into a recap. Yesterday, we had West Virginia over 14.5. They scored 14 in the first half alone. So I'm like, oh, this is a lock. They don't score the rest of the game. You know, they get down in the red zone a bunch of times, and they don't punch it in. So we lose that team total with West Virginia over 14.5 versus the Oklahoma Sooners there. As they could not capitalize. I mean, they had opportunities to kick field goals, but why? When you're down big, you try to score touchdowns. And they could not capitalize there in the second half. We also had the Clemson Tigers, -24.5. Easy, easy winner there. A lot of noise about Louisville and if Clemson's going to overlook them. Louisville's a very good offensive team. Love the head coach and what he's done with his team. They've made a huge turnaround, but that defense is still abysmal, and it showed in that game. Just keep an eye on Trevor Lawrence, guys. I don't think he's right. Not sure what's going on. He's throwing a ton of picks this year. So I don't know if it's the disguises that the defense are running different schemes at him, but he's throwing a lot of picks, and I think it's going to be interesting when it comes college playoff time because nobody in the ACC can really give these guys a run, in my opinion. But so we had Clemson over -24.5, nice win there in college football. We ended up going 2-2 in college football. We had double top tiers. We had Wyoming Cowboys -17.5 against New Mexico Lobos. New Mexico's pass defense is terrible. Terrible. I thought it'd be a great opportunity for Wyoming to come out and throw the ball around. They had homecoming there at home, and they really never established the passing game whatsoever the entire game. I thought it'd be a great chance to really turn it loose, and they did what they do. They pound the rock. They played D. They missed an extra point. They missed a field goal, and we ended up dropping that one. Later in the night, 7 o'clock game, we had UCF Knights first half against East Carolina Pirates coming back off a bye week. Plenty of time to get ready for a bad team, and they came out and beat the brakes off them in the first half. -20.5 in the first half was the line, and we covered that nice and easy for you guys. So we ended up pushing in college football. We did have one MLB play, and that was the Houston Astros on the money line. Altuve, guys, what a legend. Walk-off two-run shot there in the bottom of the ninth to go to the World Series. Man, Houston is so good. It's going to be tough, but I'm so excited to see the Nationals and the Astros in the World Series. Great playoff baseball. This has been one of the best playoffs I've seen in a very long time, guys. Great, great, great playoff baseball. So overall, 3-2 day, plus 3 units on the day, guys. Still a winning day, like I said. Not the monster day that we had on Friday, but still a winning day. Also, the other free play was not on my card. I know a lot of folks were on Penn State. A lot of folks were on them to win and win big. We were not. We were on Michigan plus the 7.5. I know it may not have been a popular pick, but ultimately, I say to my friends all the time, I was saying it at the bar last night, I don't believe in Franklin. It has nothing to do with the talent. It has nothing to do with the team. I don't believe in Franklin. I think that he's very, very conservative when he gets leads in the game. No way this game should have been that tight. They were up early controlling the game. Second half, less than 100 yards total, I think it was, for a while there. In the entire game, they were just trying to, you know, milk the clock and just get out of there with a win. But you got to step on people's throats if you want to be elite. And it's something to take notice to that he's done in years past against other dominant coaches. He tends to just be a little bit more conservative, which can lose you some games. They won this one, but they put it in the hands of their defense once again. But we had Michigan plus the 7.5 was a nice win for you guys there on the free play, which was the big free play yesterday. So we want to try to continue to roll here. It is NFL Sunday. Like I said, Sunday fun day, $20. Any capper of your choice. make sure you jump on board. Top tiers are still good. We split yesterday, but we are now 14-2. Our last 16, I believe that is. Is that right? Something like that. I got to get the numbers. But we've only lost two in the past like 16, 17 plays. All right. 15-2, 14-2, something along those lines. I think it's 15-2. 15-2, our last 17 top tier plays. So we're still humming along there and doing great things. Hop on board, $20 Sunday Funday. Let's get to a free play. I'm talking too much and I do apologize. Sunday Funday, guys. Let's get into it. Free play of the day. LA Rams going up against the Atlanta Falcons. 1 o'clock game here. Line is sitting at 3, favoring the Rams. Open at 4, moving down towards Atlanta a little bit. Atlanta is at home, 1-1 at home this year, 1-5 overall. And we all know Atlanta is the get-right team. The defense is bad. The offensive line is bad. Matt Ryan is playing out of his mind. Only one interception in the last 3 games. I believe he's leading the NFL in touchdowns. He's definitely top 3 for sure. Playing incredible football. Jared Goff and the Rams really, really struggling. Defense doesn't look good. Offense doesn't look good. They just got straight up embarrassed last week against the 49ers in a game that the score looked a lot better than it was. Niners had a couple opportunities that Jimmy turned the ball over there where they should have scored more than they did against them. But Goff didn't even have 100 yards passing. I look for them to get right in this one. Over and under here is set at 54. We're going to take a look at the total in this one. Matt Ryan's playing great ball. I think that we see the Rams get it going here a little bit. I know that they do have Jalen Ramsey coming over, and it is going to be an impact for them on defense. They're going to try to recover there. But I expect the Falcons to be down early and have to catch up like they always do and come back. Both teams have offensive line issues. We're going to go over the total this one here. 54 is the total. We're going to go over that. I think it's a race to 30. Whoever gets to 28, 30 points is going to win this game. Both defenses are mediocre. And Jalen Ramsey will improve the defense, it's not going to put a Band-Aid on everything. So I see a lot of points scored in this one. In the LA Rams, Atlanta Falcons, over the total of 54 is my official free play of the day, guys. Make sure you take advantage of it. And that's it. I'm talking too much. The video is too long. I like to stay under 5, and we're at 7. So it is what it is, guys. Free play, LA Rams, Atlanta Falcons, over 54 is the official free play of the day. NFL Sunday, hop on board, take advantage of it. $20, full card, guys. Derek, Dimes, Ghost Picks ATS, and for all you Cowgirl fans, you know the vibes. It's been a long time since you've been to one of these, or even won one. We only got one, but this is a what have you done for me lately here type of vibe. So, let's go Birds, E-A-G-L-E-S, Eagles, whip the Cowgirls. I'm so excited for that game, guys. 3 G's a ghost is how we roll here. G times 3 is how I say it. Guys, have a wonderful Sunday. Good luck, God bless, and grind on.